You must be familiar with the equation speed is distance over time. But this equation is only applicable to a traveling object with no acceleration. It is no good for when we need to consider acceleration. There are four equations to describe an object traveling with constant acceleration. For all these equations, u represents initial velocity, v represents final velocity, s is the displacement, and t is time. I'm going to show you how you can derive all of them, starting from equation 1. The definition of acceleration is how quickly an object can change its velocity. From this, we can write acceleration as the change in velocity over time taken. Change in velocity is the final velocity minus the initial velocity. Rearranging this by bringing t to this end, we get to v minus u. Making v the subject, we get the equation v is u plus at. To derive equation 2, let us begin with a velocity time graph. Recall that the gradient on a velocity time graph represents acceleration. So a diagonal line on a velocity time graph shows that the object is traveling with constant acceleration. At time is equal to 0, this object is already traveling with an initial velocity. Let the initial velocity be u. At the end of the journey, it travels at a final velocity, v. To get equation 2, we want to find the object's displacement, which can be extrapolated from the graph by working out the area underneath the graph. To make this calculation simpler, we're going to break this down into area A and area B. Area A is just the area of a rectangle, u times t. Area B is the area of a triangle. That's half times v minus u times t. So the total displacement is the sum of these two areas. We get ut plus half bracket v minus u times t. Expand this bracket to simplify it. For equation 3, final velocity is not part of the equation. We can take equation 1 and substitute it into equation 2 to eliminate final velocity, v. By substituting equation 1 into equation 2, we get displacement s is half u plus at bracket times t. The bracket gives us 2u plus at. Then we can simplify it down to u plus a half at bracket t. So finally, we get s is ut plus a half at squared. For equation 4, again, we're going to derive from equations 1 and 2, but this time we want to eliminate t. Equation 1 can be rewritten as t is v minus u divided by a. Substituting t into equation 2, we get s is half times v plus u times v minus u divided by a. Bringing a outside of the brackets, we get 1 divided by 2a, v squared minus vu plus vu minus u squared. That becomes 1 divided by 2a. These two cancel out, so that we are left with v squared minus u squared. Taking 2a to the other side, we get 2as is v squared minus u squared. And finally, bringing u squared to the other side of the equation, we get v squared is u squared plus 2as. There we go! We've derived the four equations of motion for constant acceleration.